Good day, everyone. This is Vincent Tan speaking. This time, I'm going to talk about TOEFL Mid-Need Split, the multi-zone introduction. Meanwhile, I also provide the corresponding video linkages at the below description area just for your reference. This sharing divides into these 5 parts. Moreover, I provide the corrected subtitle just for your better understanding. Don't forget to turn it on if you need.
Outdoor unit features.
This slide is the product line up from this table. Here is the model. With an X here, that means this is our new series. We call it civilization. And number here, that means it is the nominal cooling capacity. So 18 means the nominal capacity to bid 18 kBTU. M here, that means it is multi-zone. And O here, this is the outdoor unit. You can find that there are 5 capacity with 3 cases. And the outdoor unit noise is this one. It is inverter, so it will have a range, which means at the first beginning, it will have a higher noise to achieve your required quickly. After that, we will maintain a lower capacity or lower compressor output to lower the noise also. And here we indicate that how much or how many indoor unit it can connect it. And here is the size and power supply just for your information. Last but not least, it is the recommended capacity, which is the indoor unit's capacity. Device outdoor unit capacity, it should be 50 to 150%. Compact design. Just compare these 2 diagrams. You can find that for the same apartment, for this one, only installed 1 outdoor unit, so it can offer the capacity to these 4 indoor units. But for this one, you need to install 4 outdoor units for different capacity requirement. And also for this comparison, we can save the price just like this one. And for the whole series of the multi-zone, it is single fan outdoor unit. So just compare these 2 pictures, you can find that it is more easier to for this lady to open the window, but for this one, she cannot, right? And also it is easier for the transportation.
Independent control and high performance. First is the convenience. You can open the panels of the outdoor unit, and also you can find that there are lots of the EXV. This is to control the refrigerant flow, and one for one indoor unit, which is independent EXV for each indoor unit, and also the independent indoor unit capacity setting and also control, which means the indoor unit setting, it can be different, just like this. And on the other hand, as the outdoor unit is very big, which is for this case is for these 4 indoor units. And if you just turn on 1 or 2 for the efficiency, it will be very high because the outdoor unit is too large just for these 2 indoor units. And here is the requirement, which is in park low condition. And also if you not turn on all the indoor units, the efficiency will be very high. In other words, you can save lots of the power. For the complexer, the whole series apply the green brand twin rotary. That means inside there are 2 cylinders for compression. And to achieve higher durable and also higher efficiency, we have developed and researched lots of the technology inside, including first is this one, for example, the high efficiency motor with the V-shape and high magnetic intensity to achieve it. And also this component, it is the side vent for the compression. And also to higher the durable, we make the special coating at the surface. And this is the shaft. And for this one, not only for the durable, but also you need to pump up the oil, which is located here, to here for lubrication. And also this one is the combustion chamber. You can find it. This is the cylinder. And also we apply the alloy rubber made from cryogenic process for higher durable. And also this one located here at the discharge, it is the valve to control when to discharge the gas. Also, it is a low resistance with special structure. And also this part, it is the discharge. We focus on how to lower the oil discharge.
Heat exchanger fin design. First, we go to the fin structure. Actually, in the factory design system, there are three kinds of the fin, which is the flat, corrugated, means the surface is not flat but just up and down. The purpose of this one is to increase the air turbulence. And the next is the slip, which is on the surface. We just cut loss of the slip. The purpose also to increase the turbulence when the air flow by. And as you know that the higher turbulence, also we can get a higher heat transfer efficiency, right? So from the side view and top view for these three structure, a little bit different, just for your reference. And I just confirm from the heat transfer efficiency. So definitely this slip fin can get the highest value, right? Because we can make the air volume to be the most turbulent. And the next is the water stick next. What is this one? Actually, it's very important when we doing the heat tank. So the question, why is important we do in heating? This one is important. Okay, and the reason is in heating mode, always the outdoor will generate the condensing water, right? Which means especially when the outdoor ambient is lower than the freezing point, it will generate the frost or the ice, and then we need to do the defrost, which is to make the ice to become water. And if this water can easily to stick on this fin, it will not be good for the next heating cycle because it will just become the ice quickly again. So for the water stickness, the lowest one is the slip fin, because the water can stick on this slip, and the best is of course this flat fin, but just consider the heat transfer efficiency, we will choose this corrugated fin as the Unix outdoor condenser fin. That's all for this sharing. If you still have any other questions, feel free to contact me on my email address. Meanwhile, you can also scan this QR code to access for this presentation sharing. Hasta la próxima. Suerte va. Mata. Conto.